Let's talk about other types on MetaTrader. On the MetaTrader software, when you try to place an order, you click the New Order button, a box appears. By default, you'll be seeing a red and a blue button. The red is the sell buy market and the blue is buy buy market. Click any one of that, your order will be placed with the current market price on spot. That's the market execution. Back on the order box again, when you click here, a drop down menu appears. Market executions and pending order. And when you click here, multiple options appears. There are 4 options for MetaTrader 4 and 6 options on MetaTrader 5. The terms is the same and its functionality is the same as well. These options are buy limit, sell limit, buy stop, sell stop, buy stop limit, and sell stop limit. You're wondering what are they and what's the differences between them and the market executions? These are pending order, which order are not executed now but until a certain condition is met. Let's start with buy limit. Now say for example on EURUSD, the current exchange rate is 1.1. You felt like this is not the sweet spot and you aren't entering any buy positions not until it's getting lower than that. There you place a buy limit. A pending order below the market price, say 1.09. This buy order will only be triggered when the market rate touches 1.09. Then the sell limit is the opposite of buy limit. Now for the buy stop. Say for example, you made a couple of research on the currency pair EURUSD, which you believe there's a coming uptrend, but you aren't certain about it. You thought of, I will only buy when the rates get above 1.15, otherwise this is not a solid uptrend. There, you place a buy stop order pending at 1.15. This buy stop order will only be triggered when the price touches 1.15 or above it. And the sell stop is the opposite of buy stop. Lastly, we have the buy stop limit. How can I actually simplify this? Now, I believe some of you have already heard of the technical term called the support and resistance. When a certain price level is reached, it's likely to be bounce, sometimes known as selling or the floor. We will use that as example. Now, say for example, on EURUSD again, upon starting a chart, you have sufficient reasons to believe when EURUSD reaches 1.2, there will be a bounce from the resistance zone, then another bounce from the support zone. Your assumption is EURUSD will reach 1.2 first, then bounce down to 1.15, then continue its trend up to 1.3. You're considering how can I buy at the support area while I'm not around? Now the buy stop limit came into spotlight. On buy stop limit, you can set it that the price should go up to 1.2 first, based on your assumption that this is the resistance zone that will bounce, and set the pending buy order at 1.15, the support zone. If you look at this box here, the buy stop limit, there are 2 fields you are required to fill. The buy stop price and the stop limit price. Buy stop is the 1.2 we were talking about earlier, the resistance zone, and 1.15 is the pending buy order, the support zone. So when the price reaches 1.2, the order is replaced to pending buy order. To help you better understanding it, here is an example. So this is the buy stop limit I've placed, and this is the current market price. This is my buy stop price I've placed. And pay attention to the circle tags on the left. It takes quite a while. And it was replaced to buy limit order. That's how it works. This type of pending order is particularly useful for trader who is trying to implement the ELOT wave trading strategy. Then the sell stop limit is the opposite of buy stop limit. Hope you learned something new today, and finally, thanks for watching and see you soon.